Well, thank you, Mr. Speaker. I also rise to oppose this motion. And part of the reasons as to why I oppose the motion is I was not convinced that the process that was followed at the County Assembly level, as far as the threshold and was followed properly. And I think it's important because the way that it got here must also be important and considered. But now once they were here and they were stating the grounds, I also felt that the grounds were very flimsy. When they come here talking to us about impeaching Governor Sonko because he danced to party after party in France, I feel that that's not a good enough reason. When Governor Sonko was elected by over 800,000 voters in Nairobi County, we all knew him to be a flamboyant, exuberant, flashy gentleman. So for us to now want to pigeonhole him into a suit and tie, and expect him to just sit in the corner somewhere and sign off warrants and give back kickbacks, and if not, then be impeached, I feel that that is not the way to defend devolution. As the Senate, one of our very primal duties is under Article 96.1, which is to defend devolution. And from what I have seen in the past year or so, we seem to now have become some rubber stamp puppets who will do anything to help those who want to, from the national government, who want to mess with devolution, kill it by removing anyone who does not toe the line. We want to help them get there. But is it really worth it to have a by-election in Nairobi County, because which has 10% of the population of this country, just because they want maybe to transfer, as we have seen previously, to the military, the functions of the county illegally, and maybe perhaps the governor has refused to sign over some roles to an illegal entity. But here we are helping them, giving them a hand to get there. But anyhow, at the end of the day, my colleagues, I want to appeal to your conscience. Let us not impeach Governor Sonko on such flimsy grounds. I feel that the allegations were not substantiated, and as such, oppose the motion, and I hope that most of you, if not all of you, will do the same, will do the right thing, will follow your conscience, will uphold the law and follow the constitution that we swore to uphold. But as things are going, I fear for the devolution of this country if it's in the hands of this Senate. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I oppose.
Senator Wetangula.